northwestern of the country, troops of Operation Hadar in Niger have continued to record serious successes against armed bandits with significant results. For the period in focus, it witnessed decline in criminal activities. However, within the period, there are a few things we have here for you. The troops of Operation Sahel Sanity reacted swiftly to a distress call about bandits' activities who attacked this Kiru village in Faskari local government area of Katsina State. The gallant troops engaged the criminals in a fierce firefight, forcing them to withdraw in disarray, while three of them were neutralized, with several others escaping with gunshot wounds. During the exploitation, two additional bandits' bodies were discovered along their withdrawal route, making it altogether five. Equally, three women and their infants, earlier kidnapped by the bandits, were rescued. Regrettably, we lost one of our brave soldiers who paid a supreme price in this operation. It was in an attempt to rescue one of the nursing mothers, and of course, and was hit by a shot. In the same vein, troops deployed at Dan Ali village arrested two suspected bandits' collaborators, namely Samaila Usman and Idi Bello. Similarly, troops of Operation Hadar in Daji arrested two suspected bandit collaborators at Yakira village and Kankara market in Kankara local government area of Katsina State. On the 31st of October, in the same AOR, forward operating base Kango patrol team arrested two suspected bandits at Kango village in Maru local government area of Zamfara State. Deducing from the above successes that have enumerated, it is clear that troops of the armed forces of Nigeria working with other security agencies are committed in their endeavor to end banditry and other sundry crimes, not only in the Northwest, but across the country. While the good people of the Northwest are once again assured of the armed forces of Nigeria's commitment to the safety of lives and property within the zone, they are also encouraged to avail the troops with timely and credible information that will assist them in the conduct of the operations. On the other hand, in the Northeast zone, the armed forces of Nigeria are working together with all our other security agencies have continued to sustain the onslaughts against the insurgents and terrorists. Within this period, troops recorded appreciable successes as several terrorists were neutralized, while many were arrested with caches of arms and ammunition. Between October 30th and 4th of November, troops conducted comprehensive ground and air operations. The land component of Operation Lafia Adole, under its subsidiary Operation Fireball, exhibited its operational readiness and repaired terrorist attacks on troops' location at Army Super Camp, Danbor in Borno State. With superior firepower and support from the Air Task Force, troops neutralized 22 insurgents, while several others escaped with various degrees of gunshot wounds. During the encounter, troops recovered caches of arms and ammunition, as well as equipment. Equally, troops of Operation Fireball, in conjunction with local vigilante, arrested a Boko Haram terrorist and ISWAP member identified as Mohammed Bello at Damaturu Town, Yobe State. The terrorist was arrested while trying to purchase arms and ammunition, while he was in possession of one AK-47 rifle and a magazine. He has been handed over to appropriate prosecuting agency for necessary action. Meanwhile, within this period also, the air component of Operation Lafayette Dole conducted several air operations involving both offensive and support missions. With the use of a force package of Nigerian Air Force fighter jets and helicopter gunships, the Air Task Force conducted intelligence surveillance reconnaissance missions over various locations in the Northeast. The air surveillance missions revealed terrorist activities and their hideout, which enabled the Air Task Force to execute air interdictions and strikes on the identified locations, causing devastating hits on the terrorist hideouts at Mudu and Giri Maluma villages in Borno State. Scores of their fighters were neutralized and their structures and logistics facilities were destroyed. Ladies and gentlemen of the press, from the records of these operations, it is glaring that the armed forces of Nigeria, with other security agencies working with them, are resolute in their determination to end the insurgency and achieve sustainable peace in the northeast zone of the country. A look at the North Central. In the North Central zone, troops have continued to intensify aggressive clearance operations, among others, to decisively curtail activities of armed bandits and other criminal elements. This has led to a gradual reduction in the activities of criminality in the zone. Notably, troops of Sector 2 Operation Well Punch, while on patrol at Bassa Village in Shiroro local government area of Niger State, repelled armed bandits attack. In the course of the encounter, several bandits were neutralized. Also within the period in focus, troops of Headquarters Command Army Records Lokoja, in conjunction with Defense Intelligence Agency operatives, arrested four suspected criminals with three locally made guns at Aoko Village along the Lokoja-Abuja Highway in Kogi local government area of Kogi State. In another development, between 29th October and 3rd of November, Headquarters Operation Safe Haven conducted extensive civil-military cooperation activities to cultivate cordial relations with the various ethnic groups in Plateau State. On the 29th of October 2020, Headquarters Operation Safe Haven fostered security meetings with stakeholders from Kibadu, Foka, Ngwandoroa villages in Kaur local government area of Kaduna State also. This was followed by another round of meetings on the 30th of October at Gero village in Jos South local government area of Plateau State. Furthermore, meetings were held with heads of security agencies and local government chairmen on the 31st of October. On the same day, peace meetings were also held with representatives of Fulani, Irigwe, Biro, Hausa, Afizere, and Rokoba communities in Jos South and Bassa local government areas of Plateau State and Godugodu district of Shema local government area of Kaduna State. As it is, these meetings were organized in continuation of peace and reconciliation efforts amongst the various ethnic groups in the zone. The meetings focused extensively on farmers' herders' clashes, kidnapping, farm encroachment and destruction, and other single security challenges in the state. Furthermore, on 2nd of October, 2nd of November, Headquarters Operation Safe Haven commissioned five boreholes at Angwanrana, Kurumin Masara, Boto, Zipak, and a solar energy panel project in Sabunkara Clinic in Kauru, Zangun Kataf, and Jema local government areas of Kaduna State, respectively. This was followed by the commissioning of a newly renovated administrative block at Government Secondary School Gidamwaya in Jema local government area. Consequently, the locals are requested to cooperate with the security agencies by availing them with the required information, which will be useful to our collective objective of taking out the criminals from the zone. Now, I'll talk about our activities from the South South Zone. for the period under review. Troops of Operation Delta Safe have continued with the aggressive fight against crude oil theft, pipeline vandalism, and economic sabotage in the zone with significant successes. Within the period, troops of Operation Delta Safe discovered and immobilized 3 illegal refineries containing 7 boilers, 2 reservoirs, and 2 tanks, loaded with illegally refined oil products around Oruto in Boni local government area of Rivers State. Additionally, troops in conjunction with local vigilante arrested 5 suspected cultists at the GSA community in Ethiopia West local government area of Delta State. Similarly, troops of Operation Delta State, while on patrol, arrested a suspected armed robber with locally made pistol at Ibudu Market in Warri South local government area of Delta State. Furthermore, Operation Calm Waters 2 and Operation Swift Response have continued to record more successes. Between 30th of October and 3rd of November, Forward Operating Base Ibaka, while on routine patrol around Utan Iyata, intercepted and arrested 2 wooden boats laden with 326 bags of foreign parboiled rice, suspected to be smuggled in from Cameroon. The arrested items have been handed over to the Nigerian Customs Service for further action. On the 30th of October, Forward Operating Base Ibaka Patrol Team intercepted and arrested 1 small-sized wooden boat laden with products suspected to be premium motor spirit along Umbo River, being smuggled to the Republic of Cameroon. Items recovered from the arrest include the boat, 44 of 300 liters drums for premium motor spirit, 1 pumping machine, and 2 40 horsepower outboard Yamaha motor engines. The arrested items have been handed over to the appropriate prosecuting agency for necessary action. I want to draw your attention to this particular operation in the South Zone, because I recall that either the last meeting we had, the one before that, there was a question from the House that what do we do, or what happens to arrested, confiscated, or recovered items, whether from the operational zones. Like I explained earlier, I want to reiterate that all the combat equipments, kinetic equipment, weapons, they are not automatically recycled for our own use. Whatever happens, the Office of the National Security Advisor must be notified. Of course, anything gotten from an enemy is always a suspect. So take note of that. They are recovered and handled appropriately. Appropriateness in handling is the National Security Advisor will give advice and directive on what to be done, particularly the ones surrendered by bandits. So that is it. Then from the economic zone, of course, like I told you, can hear as I enumerated them, and that is how it works. That's how it goes, and that is the procedure. The ones for the customs to the customs, NDLA to NDLA, the ones to the police, after further investigations, then the proper necessary actions, probably like charging them to court for the offences or whatever goes on. So on that note, so much for that for the week. Of course, we must have gotten reports, some that I permit them. The DMO headquarters here permit them to release from the various operational areas, particularly from the Northwest, the ones you see released by our director, Brigadier General Oyoku, authentic. Anyone that you hear from any other sources, like some from Operation Safe Haven, because of the urgency, we authorize them to release, you can use. So you can rely on them as authentic. So, like that, and there was another one from Operation Awase. All those ones are authentic. We delegate, I delegate, say release. Because anywhere they are on the ground is better. Any information that I will request or demand or require, that requires confirmation before going out, I will ask the operation, the media officer there, either for the operation, for the formation, to go and check, and then on the spot check, he will now cross-check with whatever he needs to cross-check with, and I will authorize the release. So for such, because I've discovered that sometimes most of you will cause to us, it's good if you can cross-check with Sani or any of the officers and tell you that. That is why you see that despite the centralization we talk about, there is flexibility to avoid, you know, misinformation. So that we also can have evidence that we ask our officers to go and check, or our operative to go and check, cross-check what information they are giving us up here. Ladies and gentlemen of the press, the Military High Command commends all the gallant troops of the armed forces and personnel of other security agencies involved in various operations across the country for their commitment, determination, and dedication so far. And we hope it will continue. And definitely it will continue by the reason of our training and commitment to securing the country. They are equally encouraged to remain firm and decisive in curtailing the activities of all criminal elements in the country. Members of the public on their own are hereby assured that the armed forces of Nigeria, working with other security agencies, will continue to tackle the security challenges and will ensure that normalcy is attained in all the geopolitical zones of the country. However, their support is highly solicited in the area of providing credible information to assist our operations. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, this morning, for your attention. At this juncture, I would like to take any clarification.